It was late one fall night at a fairground near town when Esther first saw the Armenian man, who groveled toward her and stood by her side with a bucket that swung in his hand. His grin stretched the folds of his pasty white cheeks, and his lips hurled a dollop of murk on the curb, and the lights from the rides showed a mischievous sparkle that flashed in his hollow-eyed stare. He said, "Little girl, you can chop off my legs and then peel off my socks if you want to. But I'd rather you took this old puppet from me that I hold in my pail as we speak." And he stood looking down at the innocent girl, and she stared at the bucket, bewildered. Then he lifted the doll for the young girl to see, and a giant smile grew on his face. She saw the doll's eyes, and she couldn't resist, and she thanked the man quickly and ran to the church. And she burst through the doorway with puppet held high, and a hush filled the chapel, and the people looked mean. Esther tried in vain to pacify the mob, quibbled to spat, to wrangle, then to brawl. The frenzied congregation struggled desperately to fetch the pretty puppet snugly nestled deep in Esther's leather sack. Through the window of the church a storm began to rage, and Esther knew the time had come to flee. Scurried down the aisle toward the doorway in the distance and out into the rainstorm where she felt she would be free. But the wind was blowing harder and her skirt began to billow until finally her feet began to lift. And she rose above the houses and the people and the chimneys, and Esther and the doll were set adrift, floating higher and treetops. They flutter and glide, soaring and turning, suspended on air. With the earth far below them, they tumble and dive through the clouds. Thank you. and she began to tumble earthward till she landed in the nasty part of town. She glanced about the village, sure to find the evil men who rob and pillage in the darkest hour of night. Nervously she fumbled for the pouch that held the puppet on her rump. Feeling quite outnumbered, Esther hid behind a nearby pile of lumber, where she waited till the dawn. 'Cause it would have been a blunder to succumb to a hoodlum on the prowl. Tiny little arms around her ankle, and it wouldn't let her go.